First of all, hello. My name is Noriaki Takamiya from NTT Software in Japan. I'm glad to have such an opportunity to give a presentation to you. This is the first time to give a presentation in Asterisk, so please be patient about my English. My topic is about Asterisk on the middleware, which provides high availability and dynamic scalability. So this is today's agenda. First of all, let me introduce about my company and relationship with Asterisk. Then I describe the requirement about our customers to the Asterisk. Then I introduce the system overview and a little bit more precisely. As a first, about NTT Software Corporation. Our company is totally owned by NTT. NTT means Nippon Telegraph and Telephone Corporation. It is the largest Japanese telecom company. So we are a member of NTT Group. We provide emerging technologies derived from NTT R&D laboratories. We are working together with them. So speaking of Asterisk, we started to provide telephony solutions based on Asterisk since 2006. Our main solution is a gateway for NGN deployed in Japan. It is operated by NTT. Also, we have many other solutions based on the Asterisk, such as video conference gateway. So there are many video conference terminals worldwide, but it is difficult to use in NTT's VoIP service. So we use Asterisk as a gateway for video communication for the VoIP services. The second is the intercom system. So as I use, staff in the shops or restaurants uses these intercom systems. So we use Asterisk as a ship gateway for this system. And third line is a video distribution system. So we realize a video distribution system using Asterisk on the VoIP service. It is very useful when, for example, the sports, baseball broadcast or football broadcast, but if the people can't go to the stadium, so the people can watch the game at the different places. And we have so many solutions using Asterisk. So we started to use Asterisk for customer solutions. But our customer have some requirements to us about the telephony system. So main requirement is the following three pieces. The first case is the scalability. User wanted to use scalability regarding to the amount of endpoints or call traffic. Second part is redundancy. PBX, our customer uses Asterisk as a PBX or a SIP gateway. But they expect that the service don't stop. So our customer expects the redundancy. Also, some of our company customers request the call recovery or call continuity even if the gateway or PBX is failed. The third requirement is multi-tenancy. This request is mainly from service providers for our customers. They want to give Asterisk multi-tenancy functionality. Nowadays, we can provide a redundant system using heartbeat or pacemaker and other solutions. You can see in the exhibition room or so and so on. But call recovery can't be provided by this architecture. But there are some platforms which provide the above services. In this session, we introduce the philosophy called Netrosphere and the key platform called Magonia. With this platform, we think we can make Asterisk more powerful telephony system. Then, I will introduce the concept of Netrosphere. Netrosphere is a concept from NTT. Netrosphere means is divided into two words. The first part of Netro means make use of the experience in the internet to the future services. We have many services over the internet, and internet protocol is and SIP is used very often. We make use of such an experience on such experience to our future services. And sphere means ground, so it's a coined word for merged two words. Yeah, our target is very wide, from the end users to the ITSP or many service providers. Its policy is that provides the small building blocks, and the user can combine the functionality or services as they need instead of providing a big monolithic system. It is difficult to say, so we can use images from the website. It is one of the NTT's websites. So in most cases, we provide monolithic systems to fit each customer. But it costs very high and very expensive, or it is difficult to reuse the functions. So we think that but each system has a common functionality or services or data structures. So we divide it into these functions to reusable styles. Then in Netrosphere, the function is divided into the common cases. And then developers can choose the functions they need. Then user can provide the service on this architecture. Then we will introduce about the Magonia. Magonia is a new server architecture in Netrosphere concept. The name is after French myth. How many people do you know about Magonia? No. It consists of the following service bases. The first is a distributed processing base, which provides load balancing, data redundancy, and relocation, and so on. Second part is a maintenance management base, which provides an automatic scale out or scale down, and so on. The third, last item is a system base, which provides resource orchestration or management. So It is the image of service on the Magonia. In, because of distribution processing basis, it provides the following services. The first part is the load balancing based on the amount of traffic. For the left picture, in the left picture, users can use the services on the Magonia. In the Magonia system, the traffic from the user is divided to each virtual machines. Then, user can use these services without stressful. Second part is data duplication and sharing. It, in the middle pictures, the data used between use the session between the end user and the servers is copied during the VMs and shared each other. When some virtual machines failed, then this virtual machine is removed out from the from a cluster. Then new VM is added to the cluster. So this service is not stopped, even if some virtual machines are failed. The last part is dynamic scale out or scale down. In the right picture, the service, for example, the service is deployed in a cluster, which consists of four virtual machines. But when some traffic is increased, then virtual machines is added automatically. Then totally the service is provided by five VMs in a cluster. This is a very complicated framework in the distribution processing base. The top layer is applications. For example, Asterisk or some services. In the bottom part, it is a core system in the distributed processing middleware. For example, message dispatching, including load balancing, is controlled by the managed dispatching. I will tell more detail later. And the third block is data management. This function manages the data created by a session or user and server's connection. In this function, data is constructed as a container, which is called a container. And the container is duplicated in a cluster and shared each other. When some VM is failed, this data is used for the failed clusters, failed virtual machines. So data is not lost. The rightmost part is system management. It includes the member management in the cluster. For example, the number of VMs in the cluster or, and status in each VM. So API or overview about the Magonia for more detail, please see these URLs. So I will describe more precisely about the data traffic. First of all, the traffic from users is received by a load balancer. Load balancer distributes each traffic according to the simple condition. you can imagine that load balancing is distributed regarding, for example, IP address or port and protocol and so on. In this layer, the distribution to each VM is very simple because load balancer is not a part of Magonia. Once some VM are chosen and receive the traffic packet from load balancer, the VM examines the packet, the data in the packet more precisely. In this part, we call a dispatcher. In the dispatcher, the packet the data in the packet. For instance, Asterisk uses SIP traffic. SIP traffic includes a caller ID or caller ID to identify the session. So, for example, the dispatcher checks the caller ID. Then, if some condition matches to the caller ID or system load average, the dispatcher detects that this packet should be processed to myself or dispatched to other VMs. But in this level, there are two level load balancing. Here, one is a load balancer, two is a dispatcher in the Magonia. After that, the service logic is received. Service logic receives the data from the dispatchers. In that time, the data is copied in the data. Then data is replicated to each other and sharing among the VMs. It is a basic receive action in the Magonia. So, about the benefits of Magonia. So, we have three benefits from Magonia to apply the Asterisk. One is reliability with core continuity. This platform invokes the multiple virtual machines, as I said in the previous slide. And they construct a clustering system. In this picture, Asterisk 1 and 2 is in the same cluster. If one of this is failed, the calls processed in this virtual machine is continued on the another Asterisk. In this example, if Asterisk 2, number 2, has some SIP sessions in this Asterisk, when this Asterisk is failed, then the data stored in the management system or in Magonia is copied to the Asterisk number 1. Then the previous call is continues using Asterisk number 1. It is a very important function for carriers or big enterprise companies. The second benefit is dynamic scalability. The number of virtual machines in a cluster can be dynamically changed. We can deploy the Asterisk system with minimal virtual machines in a cluster. For example, at first we can start only one Asterisk system in a cluster. In this situation, if traffic is increased, the performance of existing VM virtual machines is not enough to process the traffic. management system at the extra virtual machine to meet the capacity of required traffic. If the traffic and load are decreased, unused virtual machines are shut down. It is very efficient for ecosystem. In this picture, at first, asterisk number one is the only server in the cluster. After that, if traffic is increased or asterisk number one have many sessions, then Magonia system checks asterisk number one only is not enough to process the services. Then asterisk two is added to a cluster. If the session is decreased or asterisk number two is not used anymore, asterisk number two is decreased. The third benefit is distributed operation. Using Magonia are deployed on the distributed regions and interact with each other. It is very efficient to survive against a regional disaster, for example. For example, some services are deployed on these platforms, which are running in region A and B. Region A is San Francisco, or region B is Boston, and so on. If each Magonia system works each other and exchange the data using, in this picture, yellow arrow indicates that region A and B is exchanging the data in each region. If region A is totally failed, the total service is switched over to the region B, and then user can use the same service on the region B. So there are many benefits using Magonia for Asterisk, but there are some restrictions or rules. For example, the service module have to be implemented as a thread, not a process. So, and which is called a distributed management system. So main function of Asterisk have to be run as a thread. I will describe that later. And to share data, I said the data container and so on. Between the VMs in the cluster, data structure have to be serialized. Serialized data is a key value store. And then we have to decide which traffic is dispatched to the specific VMs from the key data, from the traffic information. In the previous slide, I used the example as using SIP and caller ID. But it depends on the user which uses Magonia. Some user can use IP address or protocol for distributing the process to each VM in Magonia. To meet the above conditions, there are some methods for Asterisk to use on this platform. So this is a picture of example image of porting Asterisk on Magonia. From the left side, Asterisk is modified as a thread module. In this case, Magonia can use Asterisk service easily because Magonia invokes the thread invokes Asterisk as a thread. It is a normal manner in Magonia. But there are many modifications to do this. But we can make use of full functionalities of Magonia platform. The right picture is to make an intermediate module as a thread to communicate with the Asterisk. In this picture, Magonia invokes the intermediate functions. This intermediate function acts as a bridge to the Asterisk and end users. Asterisk is invoked as a normal process. So it is more easy than left side to make use of Asterisks on Magonia. But there are some intermediate inter-process communications. So there will be some overhead in the virtual machines. So it is the current status on the Magonia and Asterisk in our team. We are now trying to port Asterisk on Magonia. But currently, I am trying to port the SHIP, basic SHIP functionality in a chance SHIP driver. And related functionalities with chance SHIP. Because it is very modification against the Asterisk. So we are trying to trying to succeed in the call recovery. Afterwards, we will try other functionalities, which means holding or transferring or any other functionalities related to in the Asterisk. So, it is a summary slide. In our company, users are expecting Asterisk should be more scalable and reliable. And Netosphere and Magonia is a good solution which meets these requirements. We are now implementing Asterisk on the Magonia platform. Then, if one of you are interested in the Magonia systems, let's work together. And, let's work together. Thank you. That's all. Thank you for my presentation.
All right. Does anybody have any questions that they'd like to ask? I see some smiles, but I don't see any hands. Is anybody brave enough to ask a question?
Where can we find better links for the software? I'm looking online and I can't really find much except for things on PR Newswire about Mongonia and Netosphere.
Could you say something again?
Sure. He is looking for any links or documentation about
Mongonia. Yes. I can provide information, but is this slide available for listeners?
Does anybody know if this? I know the slides will ultimately be available. I don't know how quickly they're going to be made available. Oh, hold on. David has an answer. David says the slides will be available online in 3 weeks.
Thank you.
All right. We have a gentleman up here with a question.
Oh, so the configuration part that you were talking about, do you have it working or you were just showing us the architecture that this is how you propose to work?
Just that. Which slide?
This one. So we are showing this middleware. So do you have it working somewhere, or this is what you are working on right now?
Working online? I'm sorry, but it is a closed project in our company. Sorry.
Okay. Yes, but I think I think he said that they were currently in progress working on it, beginning with some of the SIP functionality. All right, anybody else? All right, thank you very much.
Thank you.